Welcome to the Jeanette Joy Show. I'm Jeanette Joy with Joy TV, and today I'm interviewing my great friend, Brian Horan, who I met in Melbourne a few years ago because of a tweet.
Exactly. That's right.
And Brian has a company, eCareers Academy, in a city near Sydney, but what's the name?
It's called Wollongong.
Wollongong.
It's an Aboriginal name. And it's hard to pronounce.
Okay. And can you tell me, what does a careers counselor do? What is a careers counselor?
Well, I think a careers counselor is, it's an incredibly privileged position, because you are taking young people, teenagers, young adults at a very vulnerable stage in their life, where they're not too sure what to do with their life as far as their careers are concerned. So I spend a bit of time finding out what they're good at, what they're interested in, what their gifts and talents are, what their ambitions, what their dreams are, and we try to match that with a particular career. But then a few other things I do is to help them overcome obstacles that they have about education, that they have about some things, preconditions that they think, well, a person like me can't do that. But they quite possibly can. I have an example of a girl in Canada. 4 years ago, 3-4 years ago, I spent time encouraging her to go to art school, because she's a brilliant artist. But she said this to me, which nearly floored me. She says, but I'm not academic. I can't go to art school. I said, why not? It's because I'm not good at maths and physics. I said, you won't need maths and physics at art school. She goes, really? I go, yeah. And guess what? Within 6 months' time, she's going to graduate an art student and be able to go out into the world and to apply the gifts, beautiful gifts and talents that she's got. So it's a very privileged position, Jeanette, to help people plot their careers, plot their future, and often plot their destiny.
To plot their destiny.
Exactly.
And what is your background? What makes you a good careers counselor?
I've spent 26 years educating teenagers, 15 years voluntary work as a youth worker, and I've also been an adult educator as well, and also work with unemployed youth. And when I was in the high school system, 17 years of that was spent as a careers counselor.
Oh, so you were doing this in a high school situation in Wollongong. Did I say that right?
You did.
And now you're spreading this throughout the entire universe, right? The world.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, that's why it's called eCareers Academy, because it can be done via the internet. I can do this right across the world.
So it's eCareersAcademy.com?
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, that's so interesting. And so what specific services do you provide to the students or to parents?
That's a good point, because not only do I do it to the client, it's also their parents as well. Because one thing that parents get to, especially with the teenage years, they've reared their child, they want the best for them, they've educated them, and something crazy happens in the teenage years where they do not have confidence in sharing things and taking advice from their parents. So there's, the way I look at it, there's three options. They can go to their parents, which they often don't do as far as careers advice. Secondly, they can go to their peers, the people around their own age. And as we know, some of that advice mightn't be too good and they're too wise. But thirdly, you've got a professional peer, and that's me. So I'm not the parent, I'm not their peers, but I can come in and give some professional advice. So what I've introduced, Jeanette, is what I call the 3A program, or the AAA program. Mm-hmm. The first A stands for assessment. The second A stands for achievement, and the third A stands for application. So with the first one, the assessment phase, which is the most important, I believe. So we look at their talents, we look at their giftings, their dreams, and then what level of education they're prepared to do. And I have top of the line assessment tools to be able to not only figure all these things out, but to present to them 20 to 40 possible careers just for them.
And do you keep abreast of what careers are going to be really good opportunities for people?
I do, yeah. There's a lot of research that I can do as far as that's concerned. But the second A is achievement. So a lot of individuals have the intellect, but they don't know how to study, for example. They don't know how to put an essay together. They don't know how to put a research paper together. And it's also been proven that it's not necessarily those who are the most intelligent that get through university. It's those who are most disciplined and organized and motivated that will get through. So I their skills, and their skills that I teach. And the third A stands for application. So you've got this brilliant individual who's talented, skilled, got their degree, got their diploma, certificate. Now they've got to apply for a job. And that's another hurdle that I can help them with, because there are special questions that interviewers ask at the interview. Or do you realize that sometimes when they're sitting with the secretary or the receptionist, that's also part of the interview?
No.
And they don't realize that, especially with certain airlines as well. So little tips like that, mm-hmm. How to answer difficult questions, that's the application phase. But it could also be applying for a scholarship. You might have a talented individual. I know some institutions, there are over 300 scholarships, and it's not all related to intelligence. It's often related to their contribution to the community and what they can bring to that university. So it's how to apply for a scholarship. So they no longer, at the end of their whole degree, have a bill to pay. And I can help them do that.
Oh, I wish that I had known you about, 10 years ago, when all of my children were starting to go to college and exactly. No one knew what to do. Actually, I think I need a career. Can you help me?
You're doing a brilliant job.
Okay, so will you share some of your success stories with us?
I'd love to, because they're the things that warm my heart. Besides Stephanie that I told you about earlier on, I was skiing in Whistler, and I was watching a couple of guys play pool one night after a bit of après ski, and a waitress there was she wasn't in a good mood, let's say. And I just said to her, are you okay? Is everything all right? And she grumpily said, yes, all right, and stormed off. She came back and apologized and said, look, I'm at a crossroads in my life, as a lot of my clients are. So I don't know what to do. I know I'm talented, I know I'm gifted, but I don't know what to do. I said, well, you found the right person. And I had my careers laptop with me. And so we met in a coffee shop. She did her assessment, and then she did this. She pointed, said, that's what I've been thinking about doing. And it confirmed it for her. I hadn't heard from her for about 2 years, and I get an envelope from Canada from some financial institution. And you know how sometimes you think, how did they get my address? Mm-hmm. And I open it up, and I didn't know who it was from. Looked through this financial advice, and there was a picture of her with a name underneath, with her qualifications, with a note saying, you have changed my life.
Aww.
And but that hasn't stopped there. It blows me away what happens with these scenarios. I spent time with a 17-year-old who's so intelligent that the educational system couldn't control him. He had to be homeschooled, and he qualified for university when he was 15, but he didn't know what he wanted to do. And according to his family, he was like, whenever he would walk into the room, he was like a tornado. He's causing turmoil wherever he went, because he didn't know what he wanted to do. I spent 4 hours with the guy, and he now knows what he wants to do. We got him pre-entry into university. This year he's going into engineering, and I've also lined up a scholarship, or put him in contact with some people for a scholarship with the armed forces, and he's going to become a pilot.
Oh, well, that's fabulous, a pilot.
But the feedback I got from the family was that there's peace now in their home. And oftentimes it's also a matter of being a professional peer, of speaking confidence into them and helping them over those hurdles. And not only does it change a life, but it can change a family. Mm-hmm. And I'm getting repeat business as a result of that, and referrals. There's a lot of satisfied customers, and I can't believe how much it means to people. And it's changing me as a professional to put more time into it, to really believe in these young people and to do the research, as you said, mm-hmm. To help them get over those hurdles, to find that career. It's funny, people say, so what do you do? You know, when you're in conversation, so what do you do, Brian? I said, well, have you ever heard of the saying that when you find a job that you love, you'll never work another day? I said, well, that's what I do. I help people find that job. And that's so satisfying, I love it.
So how can we find out more about the eCareers Academy?
Probably the best way would be my website. So it's www.ecareersacademy.com. Hopefully they can understand that with my Australian accent.
ecareersacademy.com.
Exactly.
I got that. It's not .au, it's .com.
.com.
Okay.
It's international.
Thank you so much for visiting with us today, and I really appreciate your friendship.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Okay.